My life as a child was a very challenging life. We've been brought up in a very humble family background, and bearing in mind that our parents really struggled to bring us up, I was born in a family of three. My elder sister, who apparently was killed 2 years ago by her husband, and my younger brother, of course, Noah Amunga, who lives in Nairobi. It's been a very challenging life all through. We've been through rough roads with my parents not having a place to live in. I remember once we slept on the streets of Kakamega town for many days without a home. I remember we went hungry for many days without food. I remember our education being a hassle for my parents. They never were able to raise enough money to take us to school. And it's just by the grace of God that we managed to go through some education. And it's quite a complicated story. And whenever I recall that, that song really appeals to me. And every time I sing Umenitoa Mbali, it's a testimony of how far the Lord has brought me. Because of all the people, you'd never imagine that somebody like me would be on this show right now in the United States. I remember way back in the early 70s, my mom would gather a lot of her friends in our home, and she would convince me to sing for them. I was about 5, 6, 7 years old, and I remember I used to sing to a lot of our visitors. Every guest who came to our house used to ask, "Where's Abel? Where's Abel? We want him to sing for us." And I knew so many songs at the tender age of about 5. I would sing like 10 or so songs off head, and even some of the hymns. Having been brought up in the Anglican church, I know a lot of hymns from the church, and I learned from my parents. But when I grew up, I actually picked up the music industry, or rather music as a ministry, on a serious note in 1985, when I accepted Christ in my life as my Lord and Savior. And I joined a church choir, and then I became a very active member. That's when I took up music seriously, and then from then on, I've been going from step to another step, from glory to glory. My experience, actually, you know, like anyone else coming to the US, you'd expect to meet a lot of Americans, of course. And every time people speak to you from back home, they ask you, how are the Americans responding to your music? Apparently, my answer to them has been Kenyans responding to my music in America, because it's been tremendous. It's been overwhelming. It's been unexpected. When I came here, actually, I never had an itinerary. I didn't know that I was going to go to all those states. What I knew I was coming to Maryland. I knew I was coming to one or two churches around Maryland and visit with my friend and go back to Kenya. But apparently, as soon as I got here, ways just started opening up, and I ended up going to many states. And I've had an opportunity to meet with so many people that I never met before, people that never knew me before. And more so, the Kenyan family that is over here in the US. What stirred me and what brought up the music element in me was my new relationship when I embraced Christ as my Lord and Savior. That's what brought the music in me. And I could never bring out anything apart from His. Because then I realized that every music that is in me is His. And even if I take a beat that looks like the worldly beat, it's His, because all the music belongs to God. That's what I believe. It's the context of the music that distorts the meaning of the music. But the music, all music belongs to God. That's what I believe. And therefore, reason why I cannot do secular is because I've been called by God. And I realized that He gave me the talent, and I have to serve Him using that talent. I would like to say that the more young men I inspire out there, the more young men I pose as their role model, the more humble I become. And the reason why I think most of them choose, most of the secular musicians, of course, to be their role models and their heroes, It's because of the quality. They are so much ahead in music. Their music is well arranged. They take time to record their music. They take time to produce their music. And that's one thing I want to talk to Kenyans about. Because we rush so much in our music, we do not take our time to make sure that whatever we bring out to the world is a finished, finally finished product that is going to, you know, to last for as long as we live. We want to bring out something in the market that is just going to come up as form, and then in a little while, it's gonna go off again. The only challenge I've had with my album, the current album I've been going around with, is the one thing I'd like to say about Kenya, and frankly about Kenyans in the US, is that they are so much still tribal based. That one I've discovered. And that when I come up with an album like my CD, Unastahili Bwana, a lot of them will see some of the Luya tracks there, and they will look at them and say, hey, I cannot buy this because it has Luya songs. I'm like, hey, Luya is from Kenya and you are from Kenya. Why don't you buy Kenya to promote a Kenyan brother? This is one of your languages you should be proud to identify with. Show one of your friends from America that this is called Luya and this is from Western Province in Kenya. That's my country. We need to embrace the Kenyan culture as a corporate thing, not as a regional or divided thing. We need to like bring up Kenya and make it one before we even venture to go into Tanzania, into the Banyamwezi and Bahehe and by the Bachagas, and before we venture to go into the Nyankoles and the Basogas and the Bagandas of Uganda, and before we even think of going to Rwanda. We need to first of all clear our mess within Kenya, be able to embrace one another as one country, one people, brothers. I should say to my fellow Kenyans that my experience in the US has been just excellent, it's been fantastic. And usually I want to warn most of the young men in Kenya want to come to the States. Think twice before you make up your decision. What do you want to come into? Do you just want to come to the States because you had so and so is in the States, or you want to come to the States because you've seen on TV, you've seen on the movies about the United States, and probably you think there's gonna be huge money, sums of money, there's gonna be fame, once you get here you're gonna make it. I want to tell you that if you come here, you should know what you're coming to do. Otherwise, don't come here. Stay back home.